Hi, Scorpio. Okay. Those of you new to Opal Oracle, welcome. Anyone returning? Hello. Hi. Hello is actually a really bad term. Hi. Hi there. Greetings. Okay. I just need to show you these cards, Scorpio, because I also realized something. Happy New Year, by the way. Well, Gregorian calendar year. Happy last quarter of the zodiac here, getting into it. Happy Capricorn season. It's very interesting, right? Jupiter in your first house of expansion, and then Saturn comes home into Capricorn. And I actually don't know, but I should find out where that, how that affects you. Because it obviously affects us all. Now, you have to come down and see these cards. It's pretty intense. Like, in a good way, but let me see if I can, hold on. This might be a little janky for a sec, right? Come on, technology. I used to be high enough, shit. One sec. You know, reality. And that comes, says the thing. Okay, that's pretty good. So, excuse the chair also, I need to oil that. So, check this out. This is what you want. Six of Pentacles. Okay. It's just very interesting, this scale here. Note that, okay? What you know. Chariot. Forward momentum. Figuring out the path. You know that there's a change, right? You know that it's a challenge, but you know that that challenge is going to bring you somewhere good, right? Somewhere more fair, somewhere more balanced within your money, within your mind, whatever. How you feel that you are changing. For some of you, you really are starting to feel a lot more in tune with your own, whatever that religion is that you subscribe to, whatever that those traditions are, those rituals. I see that there's a change in whatever your structures were. It's wonderful, really. This is Cancer's card, by the way, and this is Taurus's card. So we have water like you, and then earth. And then this is the reality of the situation, is the Lovers. It's Gemini. It's two sixes on either side, too. It's interesting. Sandwiching. Then you also have Major Arcana, the Justice card, which is Libra, the side, and that obviously comes before you. And it's interesting that these two, so you actually received all these extra cards. Usually this is just one. This is the center. This is the message from your, this is your strength right now. Water, water, water. Amazing. Eight of Cups, Three of Cups, Page of Cups. Heart of the matter, though, what's this situation? Can you see that? And it's fascinating, right? This, the younger one, this knight, charging right into all of this water. Heart of the matter. Then we have the Queen. So much more stoked. Look at these faces. You know? She's just like, yo, look over here. They're holding the same sword. But this is your weakness right now. This is the heart of the matter. So that shows me that there's two... Well, and I guess I gotta pick this camera up because it's too much like this, but... You also have this, the Fool and the Sun on the bottom, okay? That's a lot of Major Arcana. One, two, three... Four, technically five, with the Fool, and that's how you feel right now. It's five, okay? And I just put the Moonstone on top of that, which this didn't come from the moon. I just want to organize myself. Well, your strength right now is that you can, that you know, you're starting to, what's the word? I heard maneuver through your feelings, like your internal waters, okay? See that your strength right now also is you kind of like keeping it surface. Like when you're around friends or family members. I mean, this is still end of December, so there's, you know, people are still celebrating holidays. The holiday season continues, of course. And then it all depends, again, what you subscribe to, but this is just the time of year that's a little more social in that way. But even if you don't celebrate the holidays, I guess it's just when you're out and about, again, well, I heard that people can tell that you're emotionally changing. I see. And one way you want to, like, just hurry up and heal the process. But there's some sort of balancing that's going on that is out of your hands. Scale. Scale. Balancing. Two people. Two people of the same situation. Two wand cards. This guy's the two of wands. The only one that you're actually in interesting. All right, we'll take that. The only two that you're in control of. Is you in the emotions inside of you. You and your psyche. Well, I just like threw that card on top of this Ace of Wands, which is in, this is a message from your shadow side. So I actually want to say for those of you who are creative, the Page of Cups is also here too. He can be like a little artist, he can be an artist. But whenever you are trying to sort out, I heard when your mind starts doing circles, right? I know most of you are creative, okay? So you just, whatever that is, go do that thing, okay? Because that's how you move from the one, this is the advice or the overall outcome, to two, right? We're going in order. This shows up, and this is your shadow side, so it's like, hey, because sometimes our light side, you figure that a light side would always be, like, on our team, right? It would never steer us wrong. But the thing is you can't just always, it's like, if you had two other siblings and you only ever hung out with one of them, there was three of you, you know what I mean? Like, that's not fair, you can't do that. Because the other one becomes resentful, or the other one becomes neglected. Something becomes neglected. Okay, it doesn't, there isn't a balance to it. And that, and actually these two are both these scales go up the line into your shadow side, into this ace right here. Okay, so there's something really important about you finding your center in what it is that you create. Cool. Good. And actually, this examination that you'll be doing, whatever, he's looking the same way that the Fool is looking, the same way that this Page is looking, the same way that this Fairness is looking. They're all doing things with their right hand, but they're all going left. Actually, the only one that isn't doing anything with its left hand is your element, is this Page. So, and you know what, don't they say that and this is, I don't mean to spread or to continue any kind of magical spells that have been happening, so release me from the burden of being manipulated by society for a second. Like, when they say the left-handed path is supposed to be, like, Satan or the devil or whatever, like, occult sort of things, but not necessarily tarot. It's, like, from what I can understand, it's a little bit more... I thought it was wonderful. It's, like, the right-handed path, the left-handed path. What are we doing? Again, light and shadow, but that isn't necessarily good, bad, always. In, you know, particularly to each one, but they're... The left hand, your left hand ain't doing nothing, so, and this is Capricorn season, it's the double card. Basically, you're going to be tested in a way, because I see for some of you, you drink, okay? That's not, that's what your left hand is doing. I see for others of you, what your left hand does is, well, no one sees what your left hand does. Whatever that thing is that I heard that you're addicted to. But it doesn't have to be something necessarily in that realm of, like, standard addiction. It could be more, what did I just see? Idle hands are the devil's playground. I also see that the message from your light side is whatever you're trying to, well, of course the standard word here is juggle. But usually this is like trying to handle other people's imbalance or trying to balance somebody else out. You know what I mean? Like, you're trying to worry about situations that you can't control. Okay? And I see that it's timing a little bit for you. The moving forward, the changing, right? Getting to this 2 plus, this is 5, 6. 7. Eight is the strength card, so that's about patience and grace, okay? But what I was going to say about this is if you try to, see, he's just looking down at this one. If you, and this is the only, besides what you want, right? Regardless, don't over-occupy yourself with the problems of others is what I heard. You need to pay attention to your own internal waters to make sure that you are centered and continuing to move forward on this path. 5, 6, 7, you're healing, you're growing, right? Jupiter in your first house. And it just started in what, the end of October? So, you know, this is the very beginning of it. So, in a way, and this is the beginning of the new year, this is like, bam, here's this. And maybe that's why this guy has to, he's looking into this cup. Okay, and that's why his left hand, I mean, heed what I said about keeping your hands busy, but in a proactive, productive way. Okay, this isn't productive. This ain't doing shit. Okay, this can be helpful. This contemplative, yes, sure. Think about it. Where it is that you want to go. Which way is it that you want to go? What is it that you need to assess within your emotions and within the, you know, the everyday world that you need to attend to. So that I heard that the wheel in the sky keeps on turning. But really, if you continue, this is your strength. Look, all this water, Scorpio is so good. And these are good water cards. This is emotional maturity. This is you being able to handle, like, feel good. As long as you're not hiding your emotions, you know what I mean? Like, you're kind of either dealing with them in your own time, in your own way, and still balancing, like, how, as you're moving along again, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7. And if you figure out why it is that you have this fish in your cup, whatever this fish is, then you're going to have this other hand to be able to grab this, which is good. And then you'll be holding on to one of the wands, put down this shitty fish cup. You know what I mean? Whatever that is, I heard it's whatever that is that's tainted in your life, that taints you emotionally, actually, I heard too. And it kind of fucks with your creativity. But I see you ridding yourself of that, don't worry. It's like you just, there's just a turn. How many cogs was that? I heard there's 6 cogs, like that turn. But the point is that you put down that, whatever that is that's tainting you. Hold the wand. And then you really start examining, like, the way that you want it to be. Not trying to figure out what's good for everybody else. Or letting petty shit like money stress you out. Even the poorest of poor people get wasted and smoke cigarettes every day. For the people that do that. These are just examples that I've seen. But you know what I mean? Like, you always get what you want. You always get what you need. That Rolling Stones song doesn't lie. Now, hold on one sec. What do we got here? See, I turn these around. That's interesting. I put these in order for you, too. For some of you, I see that you just scale, Queen of Swords, Knight of Swords. For some of you, obviously, air signs around you. Again, Cancer, Gemini, Taurus. But I see strong Libra. I see also that, in a way, the heart of the matter is that you, it's like you're so serious, or you a kid. kind of like a Libra. At times, you know? Like a fluctuation of that. Not to say Libras are like bipolar or anything, it's just. Because everything's always moving. Nothing is never still. Nothing is ever unchanging. For those of you who want more money, or stability in that way within the physical world, I see the number 6 again. But I'm curious. Some of you started something in December. That's still happening in January. I see specifically January and something about the Capricorn. The way the Capricorn and your something about that, I guess you just started looking at, or you'll, this can also be what you will be doing. Is just looking at again what it is that Saturn's all about. Boundaries, what are your boundaries? I see particularly your external world having to do with your health. Of course, you have internal health is also plays a part in this, okay? Like the health of your own waters. Like, would you drink your own inner waters? I know that sounds wild, but really, like, what color would it be? Like, is it clear? You know what I mean? I don't know. There's something about that. I just see all this, like, blue. But this month is also going to cause you to really consider what the path is, like what it is that's in front of you and how it is that you want to move forward. I do see that there's a maturity and an elevation within that. But it's like you can only fly as high as karma lets you right now is what I heard. And the thing is like even if you're, say you're like up here having a good time, like understanding what it is that's like in front of you, what it is that's around you. Not everybody is going to as grateful to understand that, as open to understand that. And when I was mentioning earlier about like your spirituality or your religion, whatever, of course this represents your structures within yourself, your mind, psyche, whatever, your life in general. That's Jupiter in your first house shifting this. But, and actually 5 and 1 is 6. But the point of the story is that it could have something to do with God or the way that you view God or the way that you view religion or spirituality. Again, like, what is the invisible? Whatever it is that you believe in that's invisible. Because in a way, that's what the devil is. That this is just technically it's just invisible. When I used to be upset with God because a lot of people in my life died when I was young, or like just shitty, terrible, awful, horrendous things that happened to myself and people that I knew, and just like, but more than that, like even when I was very young, just the world in general, and not even two people, but like just, you know, tarring the world over, asphalting the world. But regardless of all that, when I was upset with God, I used to say, when I was a little bit of a teenager, I thought, you know, I was still upset, so I received this support that I needed, you know, whatever. When I communicated what it is that I felt, you know, I didn't feel rewarded or successful in that expression, and it never really grew into anything. But the point of the story, this is for you and me, I guess, but what I was going to say was, when I was upset with God, and when I was a teenager in early 20s and thought I was like a fucking smartass, I would say things like, believing in God's like having an imaginary friend as an adult. Fucking grow up. Like, I was mad. You know? Because I didn't understand. Whenever I'd go to the funerals, and they'd always say things like, God has a plan for you. Like, especially when that happened with my Aunt Sue, I was like, or my buddy Sketchy Bill that, like, hung himself, you know, in the tree, like, so his mom could, like, look out of the kitchen. When she, like, looked out of the kitchen window to do the dishes, he was hanging there. Always makes you wonder when the kid does it in such a way where, you know, the parent can see. It obviously means that there was some sort of situation there. I don't know where that got all heavy, but I guess you get it, so the point is that you're just going through some awesome karmic stuff. Know what your boundaries are. Call yourself out. Don't be afraid. Keep the faith. Know that if things are... Know that you're continuing to... Know and continue to work on yourself. And continue to release what it is. And I would say, if your friends were a... Picture your friends, your family, whatever. If they were a cup... If they were a cup, what does that cup look like? Or a glass, or whatever, some sort of chalice, if you will. You know? Is it a broken mug? Is it a beautiful, like, you know, I don't know. Is it like those glasses that they play songs on? I don't know. Maybe it doesn't even look like a cup when you think about them. Whatever it is that pops up, but there's something about it, like the broken cups, the dirty cups, the whatever. I heard they gotta go. And you already know that anyway. All right, I'm wishing you the best. I'll see you when I see you soon. Peace out.